बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब एंड फेसबुक चैनल्स ऑफ प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर रिजवान जमील कुरैशी। आई वाज कवरिंग मेन टेक्निक्स ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन फेज एंड आई कवर्ड कोडिंग टेक्निक्स, स्ट्रक्चर प्रोग्रामिंग, ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग, इवेंट ड्रिवन प्रोग्रामिंग, डिक्लेरेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग। द टॉपिक ऑफ कवरेज इज टेस्टिंग टेक्निक्स। व्हाट्स अ टेस्टिंग? टेस्टिंग इज अ प्रोसेस to execute the program with the intention of finding errors or bugs. So we have testing techniques. Question comes to our mind, what are the main testing techniques? We have validation and we have verification. What is the difference between verification and validation testing? Verification testing is to make sure that software is working correctly and it is executing a function without any error. For example, output of 2 + 3 should be 5, not 6. So that means there should not be any logical error and it is working correctly. Whereas validation testing is applied to make sure that software is working according to customer requirements, customer specification. What are the main types of validation testing? We have unit testing, integration testing, system testing, acceptance. Unit testing is also called component testing. In the unit testing, we test each function, each module, each object or class on unit basis. So individual components are tested independently. Components may be functions or objects. For example, Hotmail system, we have inbox, junk, compose, send message. So unit testing is applied on inbox independently, then compose, then send messages, then trash. Like ATM system, transaction module has withdraw function. So withdraw module will be tested independently. Transfer cash will be tested independently. Check balance will be tested independently, individually. Each component, each unit is tested individually, independently. We have integration testing. So after unit testing, we integrate our modules like withdraw, transfer cash, check balance, deposit cash, pay bill. Then we integrate them as one system and we test the compatibility and interoperability, intercommunication between the modules or objects or functions, that we can call one module from another or not, or vice versa. From Hotmail, like inbox, you can go to the compose, send messages, trash. That's the intercommunication, interoperability, intercommunication is tested during the integration testing. Then you have system testing. Testing of the system as a whole. After integration, the modules which were functioning, which were working individually, after integration, still they are performing their functionality as a system level, like as one system. Transaction module, withdraw, transfer cash, check balance, pay bill as one ATM system. Second example, like email, inbox, junk, compose, send messages, trash as one system. Still they are performing their functionality, individual functionality independently or not. Acceptance testing. In the acceptance testing, we call the customer to test the software. And we have two ways. We have alpha testing and we have beta testing. In that alpha testing, we call the customer at the software company side to test in front of the team, in front of developers. So it is also called control testing or contrived testing or lab test. The user will test as per the guideline or instructions of the development team. It's controlled environment. If he will try to enter, like it's a name, he's trying to enter number there, you will stop him. And there is a mobile number or telephone number, he's trying to enter character there alphabetically, you will stop him. As a development team, you don't want any error or bug will come. So you will not allow him to do something abnormal. In the beta testing, we release the software at customer side and customer can test it independently. So it is also called uncontrolled testing, or it's also called uncontrived testing. Verification techniques. We have formal technical review, postmortem analysis, walkthrough or Fagan inspection. I already covered formal technical review during the software economics course, that it's a planned meeting, planned review. We have project specs review, function specs review, design or technical specs review, code review, maintenance document. These all documents, all activities of the software processes, outputs are reviewed during the formal technical review, project specs review, function specs review, design specs review, code review. So it's planned meeting. We inform the agenda before the meeting, and all the members must be present during the formal technical review. Whereas post-mortem analysis is done after delivering the software to the customer to learn from your mistakes. Like when somebody is dead, then post-mortem is performed in the hospital by the medical doctors to identify the cause of death. Whereas walkthrough is also known as Fagan inspection. In the walkthrough, the project manager or the QA head lead will just pass by the programmer and ask him questions about the code or try to identify the mistakes. We have white box and black box testing. What is white box? What is black box? And why we apply them? White box and black box testing can be applied in the validation or during the verification. During the validation or during the verification techniques, it's sub techniques that we can apply under validation and verification. White box has some other names. It is also known as glass box or structural testing. White box testing is applied to read the structure of the code to identify bugs. Black box also has some other names. It is also called functional testing or behavioral testing. During the black box, we run the program and try to identify errors in the functionality of the software, in the behavior of the software. That is the reason it's called functional testing or behavioral testing. Thank you very much. Jazakallah khair. May Allah bless you. Assalamu alaikum.